Hello, my name is Celine Lene from the Erasmus Medical Center in Rotterdam, the Netherlands. On behalf of the co-authors, I would like to present you our study, Challenges and Pitfalls in Screening for Lynch Syndrome by Molecular Tumor Tissue Analysis. This is presented as a poster at the Digestive Disease Week 2011. Lynch syndrome is a hereditary syndrome which is caused by a mutation in one of the mismatch repair genes and up to now are known MLH1, MSH2, MSH6 and PMS2. Lynch syndrome is characterized by the development of malignancies, including colorectal cancer and endometrial cancer. The molecular hallmark of Lynch syndrome in tumor tissue is microsatellite instability. And current diagnostics for Lynch syndrome include analysis for microsatellite instability and immunohistochemical staining for mismatch repair proteins, as shown in this flowchart. The combination of these tests is known to improve molecular diagnostics on Lynch syndrome. However, the identification of Lynch syndrome remains a challenge for clinicians, pathologists, and molecular biologists. The aim of this study was to identify these challenges and pitfalls for molecular analysis for Lynch syndrome. Recently, a population-based study was performed at our institute. In a prospective series of patients younger than 70 years of age with colorectal cancer or endometrial cancer, more than 1,320 specimens were analyzed for microsatellite instability and immunohistochemical staining for mismatch repair proteins. As tumor specimens with microsatellite instability were additionally analyzed with the MS-MLPA for hypermethylation. In 12 cases with inconsistent results, further analysis was performed. First, 5 cases of colorectal cancer showed discordant results of a microsatellite instability analysis in combination with immunohistochemical staining for mismatch repair proteins, including one case with microsatellite instable colorectal cancer without absent mismatch repair protein staining, as shown here. Germline mutation analysis in this patient is pending. Furthermore, heterogeneity of tumor tissue resulted in 3 other cases in false positive conclusions for immunohistochemical analysis. In one of these cases, different areas of tumor and normal tissue showed absent and present staining for MLH1, as depicted here and indicated by the arrows. In one male patient with colorectal cancer at age 64, absence of MSH2 protein was found to be due to MSH2 promoter hypermethylation, resulting from a deletion in the EpCAM. Here you can see the results of MSH2 staining and staining for EpCAM antibody, and additional MLPA analysis showing the specific EpCAM deletion in normal and tumor tissue. In 2 cases of endometrial cancer, initially no obvious microsatellite instability was detected. Due to a family history of colorectal cancer, germline mutation analysis was performed in one of these patients and revealed an MSH6 mutation in this patient. Here you can see the result of the analysis for microsatellite instability in control tissue, normal and endometrial cancer tissue from this patient. The arrows are pointing at the microsatellite instability. So subsequent microsatellite instability analysis of corresponding normal tissues showed microsatellite instability in these cases. In case no tumor tissue from resection specimens is available for microsatellite instability analysis, the analysis should be performed on biopsies. In our study, in 1% of colorectal carcinomas and 2% of endometrial carcinomas, no vital tumor tissue from resection tissue or biopsy tissue was available for analysis. In conclusion, we found several potential pitfalls and challenges for routine molecular analysis for Lynch syndrome in tumor tissue, including discordant results from microsatellite instability analysis in combination with immunohistochemical analysis and heterogeneity of tumor tissue. These challenges are underscoring the importance of correct interpretation of the combination of immunohistochemical results and microsatellite instability results by an expert panel in molecular genetics. Thank you for your attention.